This video is a tutorial and demonstration of how you can get custom help panes in your model-driven app or Dynamics 365. Doesn't matter whichever one you're using, it's exactly the same thing. This allows you to have a panel down the side when you're looking at a screen that explains to the user what they should do. So built-in help, you don't need a third-party product to do this anymore. And you can have videos, images, bullet points, little flags on the screen. Let's jump in and I'll show you how it all works. I'm going to start here in my model-driven app, and then I'm going to switch across to Dynamics 365 so that no matter where you're coming from, you will see what you need to see here. So the concept is you're on a screen. It could be when you've got a record open. It could be on a main list view, something like that. Wherever it is, you need to provide guided help to your user about what's on the screen and what they need to do. What we can do is go in up to the top here and click on this question mark, which is how the user would enable the help. But if you've got the right permissions and settings to do this, there's a little three dots there, and you can go in and click edit. Now, in a model-driven app, it starts off blank like that. If I click across to Dynamics 365, this is a sales application, I'm on a contact record, same concept, I can click on that question mark to go into help. The difference is that Dynamics 365 already has some help built in, and it's a link to various Microsoft documents there. So we'll see how we can edit that, remove it, or leave it as part of your help pane, but just the difference there is you're starting from blank with a model-driven app, whereas you've got something to work on in Dynamics 365. So here are the things that you can do. Firstly, you can create rich text, so a description of what's going on in that screen, as well as using bulleted lists or numbered lists. So those are the first two things there. You can provide a link out to an external website. Can't yet provide a link to another help screen, but you can certainly link out to other resources. So that's what we saw there with the Microsoft Docs. You could link out to further documentation online. We've got these two things here. One is called a balloon and one is called a coach mark. Balloon will actually put like a chat bubble on the screen, pointing to something on the screen, and the coach mark sort of puts a little pulsing icon. I'll show you what that does in a moment. From there, we can also have sections. So your content in the help screen can be in different sections, and we can insert images and videos. Now, images and videos need to be hosted online. You're not actually attaching those things in here and taking up your precious storage here. So links to images that exist on the web and links to videos. Now, if you want to link to private content from your organization, you can link to Microsoft Stream. Otherwise, it also supports linking to YouTube, Facebook, and Vimeo. Let's put some stuff in here now. So the first thing I'm going to do is insert a section because I want to group things nicely. So we're going to call this section Important Details, and you can choose whether it's collapsed or not. I'm going to leave it open. So let's put in some information here, add a bulleted list, and you can do the same thing with a numbered list if you like. All right, now let's add some things that are going to pop up on the screen, balloons and coach marks. Now just add some space at the bottom there, because as you add these in, they're actually going to appear in here as well. So let's start with a balloon, and a balloon is going to pop out like a chat bubble. So let's say we want to put some information in here about the description. So we could put description requirements, and this is going to be the title of the actual balloon. And then in the details here, all right, something like that. So then what we do is we drag this and say that belongs there. You can see I can hover over it and let it go and insert it, and you'll see there that's created that little link to it, and that is sitting there. I'm going to put in a coach mark, and then we'll see how these things work. So the coach mark is less information on the screen, more just highlighting something on here. So we'll click that one. Link text will be enter the price here, and we will drag that to price, insert, and save. So the experience so far now, if I am a user, I can come along. Let's just close this. So pretend I'm a user now. I come along, I click on the help panel, and here we go. Here's the important details. If I go to description requirements, there's my balloon that pops up, enter the price here, and it puts that coach mark and highlights that on the screen for. Let's add some more. So I can go back in and edit, and now I can put in an image or a video. Let's go ahead and put a video in, and I'm going to create another section for it. So we'll say learn more about this app, and I'm just going to grab a link to a YouTube video that I've made about the app. So again, this could be something you've made in-house from Microsoft Stream. You can have it pick up at a certain start time so that it's not even right at the start of the video. And let's insert that and you'll see, there we go, there's my video from YouTube sitting in there as well. All right, there's our help panel. Let's switch over to Dynamics 365 and have a look at a few other things that we can do over there. So here's my standard starting point. I'm going to go across into opportunities here. We'll close that. And I'm going to go in and see an opportunity. So let's say we wanted to provide the user with some guidance on what they needed to do in terms of an opportunity. So I've prepared a few things here along the same lines. I'm coming in. I don't really know what I'm doing on this screen. I can go into the help screen here and we can see some more things here. Now, the first thing I've done is taken that standard section and renamed it. So again, within the edit option here, I can actually edit the section and edit that section title. So it comes up by default as undefined, change it to Microsoft Docs, and suddenly that whole bit is looking a whole lot better. And we could choose to have it collapsed by default. You'll see here I've actually used the image feature as well. So we've got an image sitting in there, and I've also got a link. So this is the ability to sort of bring a hyperlink in there. If I go insert link, you can put the URL and the link text, and that comes there, and that will allow me to click through to an external site to go out to Sales Navigator and an image there of something that's publicly available online to do that. Now, some technical details here if you'd like to know how to enable this and where the data is stored when you create all of these things. So first up, you need to go into the settings to enable this. So whether you're in a model-driven app or in Dynamics 365, you're looking for this little cog at the top here, same over here. So we can go in and click on that, and we go into advanced settings. From there, we go into the administration system settings, and you'll find the options in here. We just need to scroll down and enable custom help panes and guided tasks. That needs to be clicked to yes, and then you click OK, and that will be set up. That's a one-off thing that you need to do. Now, if you want to know where it's storing all of these things, it's actually storing it in Dataverse. If you go to make.powerapps.com, so into your maker experience, and click on solutions, you'll find that it's putting it in the default solution. So we go down to the bottom here and click default solution, and you'll see all of the different components and things that are going on in here. The thing you're looking for here is called a help page. So it's sitting there, it's storing it there in the help page. You'll see I've just edited that in the last few minutes. So if you need to move that across, if you're moving your application across different environments, you need to get that help page from the default solution, put it in an unmanaged solution, and then you can move that across to the other environment. And that's all there is to it. I think this is really, really easy to use. Any administrator can actually now just get started with building those help screens. They're very easy to get into and edit and update as you need. I hope that's been helpful, and I hope you can get started with that straight away. Thanks for watching.